Finite impulse response analysis in FSL is similar to SPM. The basic setup happens in the GUI, and you specify a window along with the number of time points you want to estimate. First, make a copy of the dataset and call it tone_counting_FSL. Before you begin, as with the other tutorials, we're going to create an onset timing file by navigating to the directory containing all of the subjects, and then copying and pasting the following code from the GitHub FSL scripts directory in convert onset times tone counting FSL. Copy and paste this into your terminal and press enter. This will create new files in the func directory called tone count run 1 and tone probe run 1. Now navigate to the folder sub01 and type feet_GUI. This will open the feet GUI. Make sure the defaults of first level analysis and full analysis are selected from the drop-down menus, and then click on the button select 4D data. Select the file func_sub01task_tone_counting_bold.nai.gz and click OK. In the field next to the output directory, type run1 and leave the other defaults in the data and prestats tab as they are. In the registration tab, set the search values in both the main structural image and standard space fields to full search and 12 degrees of freedom. In the main structural image field, we're going to first use bet to skull strip the anatomical image. So go back to the terminal and then navigate to the anat directory for sub01. This has the sub01 T1 weighted image. We're going to use bet2 and then supply the sub01 T1W.nai.gz file as input. And we're going to call the output sub-01_T1W_brain.nai.gz. Once this is done, open up FossilEyes, and we're going to take a look both before and after skull stripping to see how good of a job it did. Click on File, Add from File, and from the Anat folder, select both the skull stripped and non-skull stripped anatomical images. It's easiest to put the skull stripped one on top and then set it to a certain color. Again, we're trying to make sure that not too much of the cortex was removed. If that looks okay, you can exit it and go back to the sub01 directory and your feet GUI. Now for the input for the main structural image, select the skull stripped image. In the stats tab, we're going to click on full model setup and create two EVs. Let's call the first EV tone counting. Change the basic shape to custom 3-column format and select the file tonecount_run1.txt in the func directory. In the drop-down menu next to convolution, select FIR basis functions. As with AFNI and SPM, you can select the time window and the number of time points to estimate. Change the number to 10 and the window to 20. This will estimate 10 time points at 2-second intervals in a 20-second window after the onset of the stimulus. Click on the 2 tab, give it the name probe, and again select custom 3-column format and the file toneproberun1.txt. Use the same number and window values of 10 and 20. If you click on the contrast and F-test tab, select one F-test and then also change it to real EVs. You should see 10 contrasts automatically filled in with a diagonal of 1s for each time point after the tone counting condition, and a box selected in the column F1. Just as in the SPM tutorial, this will test whether there is any significant difference anywhere for any of the time points. We can also add 2 more contrasts by changing the contrast number to 12. And naming these additional contrasts, let's say TRs 3 and 4 minus 1 and TR 10 minus 1, and giving it the following beta weights. In the first contrast, it's negative 1, 0, 0.5, 0.5, and for the second contrast, it'll be negative 1 in the first column and a positive one in the 10th column. This will test, for example, whether TR10's activity is greater than TR1's. If you click on View Design, you should see the following image representing 10 regressors after the onset of each condition, as well as the temporal derivatives in the last 10 columns if you checked that as well. Once you're satisfied with that, you can close out of that window and then click Done, which will show the design matrix again, and then click on Save and call the output file design_run1 and save it to the directory containing all of your subjects. The link to the brain book down below shows you how to use this to script an analysis for all the subjects, but for now we're just going to focus on subject number 1 and click the Go button. This may take a few minutes, so we're going to fade out and come back when this is finished. Just like with the previous FSL tutorials, you should check the output from preprocessing and the statistical analysis by clicking on each of these links. For example, we'll take a brief look here at all the output statistical maps, including the F-tests and the individual T-tests as well. Once you're satisfied with that, we are going to view the estimated time points as a time series, and to do this, we'll need to concatenate them using FSL merge. Navigate to the directory run1.feet/stats and type the following, which I've copied and pasted from the ebook. This FSL merge command will concatenate the inputs as a time series and call the output firs.nai.gz. Once that file is generated, we can look at it in FSLeyes. Type FSLeyes from this directory, and when it's opened, click on File, Add from File, and then choose the file sub01run1.feet/reg/highres.nai.gz. Then select File, Add from File, navigate to the stats directory, and select the files fstat1.nai.gz and firs.nai.gz. Click Open. From the viewer, highlight the fstat1 file and threshold it however you want, noting where there seem to be brighter intensity voxels indicating a higher F statistic. Then highlight the FIRs file and click on View and then Time Series. You should see something like this. As you click the crosshairs on different voxels, the time series will update to show the estimated bold response to each time point in the window you specified. After this, you can run the preprocessing and first level analysis for all the subjects, and you can do a group level analysis on the time points and contrast them any way you want, and then extract time points using an ROI analysis. You have now learned how to perform a finite impulse response analysis in all of the major software packages. Which one you choose is ultimately up to you.